first part of my Hocus Pocus playthrough. A great game that I used to play all the time with my sisters when they were about my age and I was little. And it was a really fun game. So let's first look at the story of Hocus Pocus. Once upon a time, in the land of Lattice, there was an apprentice magician named Hocus Pocus. He had studied long and hard to become a true and powerful magician, one that could sit with pride on the Council of Wizards. The Council ruled this part of the land, and being a member was the highest honor. It also helped to get really good tables at restaurants. Page down. Heck. There we go. The head of the Council, Terexin, did not believe Hocus was serious with his studies, mostly because of the doodles down the side of his spellbook. So he set him a series of tasks, each more dangerous than the first. To make matters worse, Hocus could not marry his true love, the outrageously beautiful and well-drawn I love that, Popopa, until he became a member of the council. So Hocus said goodbye to his parents, Slow and Pegina Pocus, and set off to defeat the evils Terexin set before him, with only his determination and a nicely tailored magician's outfit to protect him. He also had his infinite pocket-sized lightning spell, which could also prove helpful. All power in the land of Lattice and its source in magic crystals had its source in magic crystals, gems that resonate with when brought together in sets. You must capture the crystals of each of your adversaries to rob them of their magical powers, said Terexin. And should one of the adversaries, well, meet with an accident, no one would really complain, if you know what I mean. The Council used such tests to rid themselves of pesky adversaries that posed a threat to their control of the area. The most annoying were the Mad Monks of Melanwall. These monks guarded their part of the magic paths, the dimensional shortcuts by which you could travel to the different parts and different eras of Lattice. They would charge a toll to those wanting to travel along their paths, which were among the most heavily traveled paths in the land, especially the path to the beautiful to the beautiful Amazon tribes before the time of Clothes era. This bothered the council, who wanted them removed so they could get on with their Amazon studies. Studies, of course. Back in the time of the really big shaking, parts of Lattice ripped themselves off in another space and time, connected only by the paths. Strange creatures formed in the fluctuating magic energies, and few of these were very nice. The least nice of these mutants were the tree demons. Oh, the tree demons suck. Trust me, I hate the tree demons. People had used these trees to hang swings from, build forts in, and saw bits off of so they didn't damage the roof and so on. For hundreds of years, the trees had stored up their tree anger, so much that the magic allowed their sheer peevedness. Oh, I love this. Bring them to consciousness. Since you look like many of the young lads that climbed on them for centuries, said Terexin, you may have some trouble. Oh yeah, these are going through all the tests, I forgot to mention. So this is the third test. Warped and weary. Inhabiting the most unstable and dark areas along the paths were the harsh gray dragons of Higgindome. These dragons were very frustrated and hungry because they had trouble fitting through the smaller paths which led to the beautiful princesses. They could never find any to feast on, and often had to order takeout. Oh my god, I love this. This frustration was taken out on any visitors to their lands, mostly in the form of body-scorching fireballs. These fireballs were born of the fiery bellies of the dragons, and were so fiery that even antacids could not quench them. Steal their crystals, said Trexon, or we'll be dragging you home in a box. Sort of a magician's joke, you know? And the fourth and final test. Destination home. The long-standing enemy of the council is Trelodon, former head of the council, now a sworn enemy. What started as a simple argument over which pattern dishes to buy for the council's dining room ballooned into a fierce antagonism that threatens to destroy the very magic paths themselves. This is distressing to you since they are your only way home. Trelodon means to break Lattice apart, said Terexin. Kick his stinking magic buttocks. Watch your progress. Terexin will usually project an image of himself into an area, and if he's in the mood, he'll speak astrally to you and give you a hint of nearby danger. Or, more likely, he'll be very rude to you. Good luck, young wizard. Alright, get this game started with time something. Time tripping. See, those are all the four tests right there. Time tripping. Let's do it on moderate, which is actually pretty difficult. Now, hopefully, this isn't going as slow as it looks. Alright. Crap, that's not what I can do. There we go. Come down here. Kill those. Oh, crap. Crap. Alright, that wasn't good. See, he gives you a hint. You might find a silver key to your left and up the stairway. Or you'll never find the secret treasure room in this castle. I will. So, another brave apprentice. You'll never make it through these castles alive. Baha. You are very wrong, sir. Oh, sheep. Oh, let's hide down here. Still hits me. Oh, yeah, that's fair. Boom. Take that. Crap. You're not supposed to hit them. That is no good. The lava. Lava's bad. This crystal. I think we've got most of the treasure. Screw you. I don't care. I'm almost done with the level. Alright, go here. Oh, snap. So these levers, all you gotta do is press up. Up, there you go. And something will happen when you do that. And in that case, it opened a little door. Now, we don't want to get that yet. Because we got treasure still to collect. Lots of it. As you can see. Secret little treasure room. Alright, what's this guy say? So you found the secret treasure room. Perhaps I misjudged you. You're still doomed to failure. Well, thanks for the encouragement, Pox. Right, let's get this crystal and be done. Alright, so I guess I'm running out of time, so that concludes part 1 of